Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I have met this morning Mr. Lakhdar Brahimi, the Joint Special Representative of the United Nations and the Arab League for Syria. Right now, Mr. Brahimi is briefing the Security Council on his recent visit to the region. Let me just make a few remarks in my capacity as German Foreign Minister. The situation in Syria is grave. We need to do everything we can to end the violence and the killing of so many innocent people. Germany supports the work of Mr. Brahimi in his very difficult job. Germany will continue to press for a united stance of the Security Council for an end of the violence and for a serious start of a political process that will ultimately lead to a new beginning in Syria. The United Nations must stay engaged to ease the suffering of the hundreds of thousands of refugees caused by the conflict. Germany will remain one of the top donors of humanitarian assistance. I welcome the clear position of many important leaders of the region to condemn the violence in Syria, particularly by President Morsi of Egypt. I hope this will serve us, this will serve as a wake-up call to those who still hesitate to denounce the violence caused by the regime in Syria. Deutschland unterstützt die Arbeit von Herrn Brahimi bei seiner äußerst schwierigen Aufgabe. Deutschland wird weiter mit ganzer Kraft darauf drängen, dass der Sicherheitsrat endlich eine einige und klare Position einnimmt. Wir drängen auf eine sofortige Beendigung der Gewalt und den ernsthaften Beginn eines politischen Prozesses, um einen politischen Neuanfang in Syrien zu ermöglichen. Wichtig ist humanitäre Hilfe für die Hunderttausende Flüchtlinge des Syrien-Konflikts. Deutschland hat bisher über 30 Millionen Dollar zur Verfügung gestellt und wird sich auch weiter engagieren. Ich hoffe, dass die klaren Stellungnahmen aus der arabischen Welt, vor allen Dingen auch die sehr klare Stellungnahme des ägyptischen Präsidenten Morsi, auch verstanden wird als ein Aufruf, jetzt gemeinsam zusammenzustehen und auch gemeinsam zusammenzuhalten, zu handeln. Wir sind der Überzeugung, dass die Lähmung durch Uneinigkeit des Sicherheitsrates weder der Lage der Menschen gerecht wird, in Syrien und in den Flüchtlingslagern in den Nachbarländern, noch wird es auch der Autorität und der Bedeutung der internationalen Gemeinschaft gerecht. So thank you so much, and if you want, you have now the opportunity to ask some questions, please. Mr. Peschke.
James Bates from Al Jazeera. We've heard you describe how bad the situation is, and we've seen the fresh pictures this morning from Homs of the shelling taking place. But do you have a fresh plan to stop the bloodshed?
I think we have a plan, and this is the six-point plan which has been adopted by the Security Council. And I think the substance of this plan is still the best alternative. We have to solve the conflict in Syria, but we also have to avoid a conflagration in the region. And I think this explains why we seek and why we work for a political solution.
Zu dem, was Brahimi im Sicherheitsrat ausgeführt hat, was seine Vorstellungen anbelangt.
Ich bitte um Verständnis, dass ich das, was Herr Brahimi in der geschlossenen Sitzung im Sicherheitsrat vorgetragen habe, von hier aus nicht wiederholen möchte. Es ist an ihm, dazu auch eine Stellungnahme vorzunehmen. Ich kann nur so viel sagen. Er hat so wie ich vor wenigen Tagen ja auch die Flüchtlingslager besucht. Und wenn man die Flüchtlingslager besucht hat, dann weiß man, dass das nicht mathematische Zahlen sind, statistisch gezählte Tote, sondern das ist ein Drama für so viele Menschen. Und deswegen rechtfertigt es auch jede Anstrengung in der internationalen Gemeinschaft, für eine politische Lösung zu arbeiten und ein Ende der Gewalt zu befördern. Aber natürlich ist die immer noch blockierte Situation im Sicherheitsrat sehr unbefriedigend.
Herr Minister, nach dem Scheitern von Kofi Annan, warum glauben Sie, soll Brahimi mehr Erfolg haben?
Sehen Sie, wir dürfen auf keinen Fall aufgeben. Wenn wir aufgeben, dann geben wir die Menschen auf. Wir wissen alle, wie schwierig die Lage ist. Ich erwarte auch keinen großen Durchbruch in dieser Woche. Aber aufgeben werden wir auf keinen Fall. Das sind wir auch den Menschen schuldig. I just want to repeat this in English. We all know how difficult the situation is in Syria and in the region. But if we give up now with our political efforts, we would give up the people, the families. And this is why we will continue with our efforts.
Mr. Minister, with all due respect to the good wishes for the Syrian people, what you have just said is that you revived a plan, the six-point plan, that absolutely proved that it was not implementable, and you said that is the plan. So other than an absolute paralysis in the Security Council, is this not a reflection of an absolute impotence in bringing something new to the table while it's approaching 30,000 dead? What is this Brahimi's new thing, just to revive the six-point plan?
I'm sorry, I'm not the spokesperson for Mr. Brahimi here.
That's what you said about the six-point plan.
This is what I'm not the spokesperson for Mr. Brahimi here, so I made this statement in my capacity as German Foreign Minister. I just want to clarify this because that this may not move into the wrong direction. Please understand me that I want to underscore this once again. This is his work and his responsibility, and I think it was important, this briefing, what we just had about this. I talked about the substance of the six-point plan, and I wouldn't give up this substance of the six-point plan as long as we do not see a better alternative. I'm frustrated like you are about the situation. But once again, what is the alternative? We have to help the people, we have to support the people. We have to work with all what we can, we have to do our utmost to finish the violence in Syria. But on the other hand, it is also important to be wise that we do not run into a conflagration in the whole region. This is also something which concerns me, the effects and the consequences for some neighbor countries. And I think we all agree we have to avoid that we see that this conflict in Syria set on fire one country after the other.
Just as a follow-up, sir, both the foreign ministers of the UK and France said everything is on the table, including a Kosovo-style intervention. Is that your position as well?
I do not have to add anything to what I just said about this, and we have enough meetings and many meetings in this week, and we have this subject and we will discuss this. You know that we have another meeting on Friday. We had a telephone conference last Friday. And I mean, if you just allow me to add one point, which I think is very important, I think it would be wise and it is necessary that the opposition unites themselves. We need a united opposition, not only united against the regime of Assad, but united on a common democratic pluralistic platform. Because if we want to promote this progress, if we want to promote this process of erosion in the regime of Assad, it is necessary that the people who live in this country see that they have a perspective in their country, and this includes pluralistic structures. This includes religious and ethnic tolerance. This is the inclusive approach I advise.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.